Hey guys, welcome to Tuesday Connections. Today is Tuesday, January the 5th, 2021. Happy New Year. May the grace and peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Amen. Couple of announcements today. Just wanted to, say Happy New Year, but also, you know, the vaccine is out. It's not available for everyone yet, but I just want to encourage you as your pastor. Don't know where you are, and I don't know why this is a thing. It is a thing, but I hope that you will each get the vaccine when it becomes available. The more folks that have the vaccine, the more our society can get back to a sense of normalcy. And so I want to encourage you each, when it becomes available, if at all possible, as far as it depends on you, to get the vaccine. And we're looking forward to a good 2021 moving forward. Also, at the end of this month, after a very busy December, we don't have a lot going on here at the beginning of January, which is a good thing. We do have a congregational meeting the last Sunday in January. That's January 31st. We are going to meet online at 5 p.m. So please put that on your calendar. It will be a go-to meeting or a Zoom meeting. We're still working out the best format to do that, but it will be an online meeting. Those who are presenting will be present. You will have an opportunity, if you have questions, to ask them during the meeting. But we're trying to come up with the best way to get as many people involved without having everyone all together in one place. And so January 31st, please put that on your calendar, 5 p.m., and we'll look forward to being together in that way. So today I want to piggyback on something that I said on Sunday, just in considering our flourishing relationship with Jesus Christ as individuals, as children of God who have been redeemed. This is my prayer for each one of us, that we would grow in our faith, that we would grow deeper in our relationship with God. And a lot of that has to do with how much we know God. Something I wrote in the Beacon this past week, it just kind of came out, and that happens. Sometimes I write something and I'm like, oh, that's a good sentence. I wrote that we can have hope in every circumstance because of who God is. It's not because of who we are or because of what we've done. It is because, and it's not even because of what God has done. It's just simply who He is, the nature of His being. And what's interesting about the nature of God's being is that we can never, ever plumb the depths. I've got this book called The Blessed and Boundless God. It is the works of George Swinnick, who was a Puritan author. And one of the things he says is, what we know of God in comparison to what is to be known is but a drop to the vast ocean and a whisper to the loud thunder. He goes on, how little a portion is heard of Him. Surely we hear a great deal of Him from the voice of creation and providence. You know, the stars tell of the works of His hands. That's we get a little bit of the sense of God, especially from the voice of His Word. The Bible tells us and is our guide about who the Lord is. He says unbelievers hear a little bit, as referenced in Romans chapter 1. Saints on earth hear much more, from Psalm 63. Saints in heaven hear most of all, 1 Corinthians 13 and 2 Corinthians chapter 12. But how little is heard of Him in comparison to the excellency of Him. God is so great and wonderful. We say things like God is love and God is good, but how far do we go in our understanding of the goodness of God, in our understanding and our experience in the love of God? These are qualities that have a richer depth than I would venture to guess that any of us have dared to plumb. Paul in Romans chapter 11 at the end, he gives this doxological praise. And I'm going to read this out of the Message because it brings it home into layman's terms. Eugene Peterson, the author of the Message, translates it this way. Have you ever come on anything quite like this extravagant generosity of God, this deep, deep wisdom? It's way over our heads. We can never figure it out. Is there anyone around who can explain God? Anyone smart enough to tell Him what to do? anyone who has done him such a huge favor that God has to ask his advice, everything comes from him. Everything happens through him. Everything ends up in him. Always glory, always praise. Yes, yes, yes. What a wonderful way to explain the depth of the riches of the wisdom and knowledge of God. And so friends, again, my prayer is that we would grow deeper in our relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ this year. And it begins with knowing God and knowing that we haven't arrived at a place where we know everything about Him, that there are depths of riches that we are invited to plumb. And so won't you do that with me this year? God bless you. Happy New Year. And may you have a great week. See you Sunday. God bless.